welcome back. So, wanted to do a video on an article that I found earlier this morning as I was catching up on the news. This is coming from the New York Post, talking about a clergyman living in the same residence as Pope Francis has tested for the flu bug. And as you probably know, one of the things that Pope Francis did that was a little different when he was elected Pope, he refused, well, he didn't want to live in the papal palace that was the home of the popes. He ended up moving into the Santa Mater guest house, which was built in, I don't remember when it was built, if it says in this article or not, but it was built as a result of St. John Paul II, who wanted to have a little bit more comfortable house for the cardinals when they come to elect a new pope in a conclave. So, and this is a guest house that cardinals will usually stay at when they're visiting Rome as well. But anyway, it turns out that an Italian man, it appears to be a clergy person, clergyman, cleric, priest probably, was tested positive for the virus and is being treated in a hospital. Does this mean that the Pope is sick? No. But we should pray for him all the more, even after he came down with that cold earlier this year. But as you know, the Pope has only one functioning lung as a result of, I think it was an accident when he was younger. So, as we know, this is a disease that affects the lungs greatly. And with the Pope being 83 and one lung, it's something really to be concerned about. But another article that I also came across is something that the Pope is going to be doing tomorrow on March 27th. He's going to be giving an extraordinary Ubi et Orbi address. And this is as a result of the COVID pandemic again. But it's going to be airing, it's going to be happening at 6 p.m. Rome time. And for us, that's noon central. It's going to be a special speech that the Pope will be giving with a blessing. You'll probably be able to watch it on many different websites, but I would recommend watching it on EWTN, as they usually will air papal events live, and they have a translator since the Pope does not speak English very well, and this is an address to the church as a whole, the universal church, so not just in English. But as he said, I invite everybody to participate spiritually through the means of communication. The ceremony will consist in readings from scriptures, prayers of supplication, and adoration of the Blessed Sacrament, and will conclude with Pope Francis giving the Urbi et Orbi blessing, with the possibility of gaining a plenary indulgence to those who listen to it live throughout the various forms of communication. So normally this is a blessing that's only given at Easter and Christmas, so it's a special blessing. But anyway, again, it's just a reminder that we need to pray for our Holy Father, regardless of how people view him. He is the successor of St. Peter. And as the successor of St. Peter, he does need our prayers because, as our Lord says, to whom much is given, much will be demanded. So as I usually tell parents when I'm preparing them for baptismal class or marriage preps, a parent will be judged on how they raise up their kids. A priest will be judged on how he leads his parish. If he leads his parish astray, he's going to have to answer for that. A bishop has to answer for how he shepherds the people of his diocese, and the Pope as the leader of the universal church. So, again, to whom much is given, much is demanded. So, please pray for our Holy Father, and please pray that God will lift this pandemic as soon as possible. So, until next time, God bless.